The two of you have come a distance, you've come through some years, and here you are. You're standing in front of me today. And the two of you have come here today to do, well, if it is not the most important thing in your lives, it's certainly one of the most important things the two of you will ever do together. A day I hope you plan to celebrate every year, because this event, what you two are doing, this is meant to last your whole lives. There is a scripture that pretty much everyone is aware of. I know it as a scripture, but also as a recipe for all married couples. And it says, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not easily angry, and it keeps no record of wrongdoings. Jeffrey, you take Shelley to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for richer or poorer, in sickness and health, to honor and cherish and love until death do you part.
Yes, I do.
Shelley, you take Jeffrey likewise to be your husband, to love forever, for richer or poor, in sickness and health, to honor and to cherish and love until death do you part. Now, here are your rings. Now, the way Paul says. Now, these rings are meant as a symbol of the vows and promises that you're making with each other today. You're going to be wearing these rings the rest of your life. And every time you see these rings, you're going to remember those vows and promises that you made today. So if you would take Shelley's ring, if you'll take his ring, and we'll start with this ring. Now, hold that ring up so we can see it. Repeat after me, and then place the ring on the finger. With this ring. So you can take his ring, repeat after me, and place the ring on his finger. On the left hand. With this ring, I be wed. And with it I give you all my love and all of my devotion. And place that ring on his finger. Now, you just stay right there. Just turn and face the camera. Now, I'm going to get the two of you to come and step up here. Now, before you light the candles, it is important that you realize, and I know that you do, that in being married, it's not something that just takes place between the two of you. It takes a family to have a successful marriage. So you are part of this family and their support through many, many years to come. Now I'll ask each of you to light the candle. Perfect. And then go ahead and have a seat. Now if the two of you will very carefully step up here. And Shelley, you're going to be on the candle the furthest to the wall. And you're going to come and stand right next to her. Now hold the hand. Now, in front of you, there are three candles. Two of those candles represent the two of you as you are today, as well as the family connections that are being connected to you. I'm going to ask each of you now to pick up a candle by the base and light the candle in the center. It is very important that you realize that from today and henceforth, you're no longer two people, because today you're becoming one person, one body, and one soul. Now I'll ask the two of you to step back over here and just turn and face each other. Now the two of you, you have known each other long enough to know that relationships have hard times, like today. You have known each other long enough, more than likely, and you've certainly been around long enough to know that relationships also go through some difficult times. We prefer the good times. Now, the two of you are about to spend many, many years together, and you probably will go through some of those times. And the reason I know that, maybe others that are with us here today know all this, because as married couples, we all do. It's just part of life. But it's in the difficult times that you relearn to walk together side by side and step by step as best friends, someone to help you. In the difficult times, you learn respect. And as many, many years together will go by, sometimes it may become necessary to learn and to put into practice forgiveness. Out of time, the two of you made this decision together to be married, along with the promise, some way or another, that all the good times, which is the easy part, as well as those difficult times, we're simply going to do them all together. And now, you're doing that together forever, because today marks the beginning of your forever together as America. I wish you God's blessings, His peace and joy, and really, on top of all of that, I wish you love through so many wonderful years that the two of you have had. Along with that, I wish you a very long life together. So in as much as both of you have consented together and before this company to be joined in matrimony, to honor, to cherish, and love, I, by the power vested in me by the state of Nevada, it is my honor to now pronounce you husband and wife. Please give your wife a kiss. Now, very carefully step in. Take these off. Take these photos with her. I'll put some music.